It's a little after 8, so we'll get started. My name is Jim Nichols. Most of you know me, for better or worse. So a little bit of an update on how the business is doing. Overall, Volvo continues to be very strong, both globally in the United States and also in Canada. In the U.S., as you know, the industry is down about 1.9%, but so far year to date, Volvo is up 4.7%. In Canada, we're still seeing very good growth. We've seen very good growth over the last few years. Currently, the Canadian market is up 6.2% for Volvo, whereas the industry as a total is down 4.8%. One of the things that has been fueling this growth, of course, has been Care by Volvo. Care by Volvo is still in the United States the only national flat rate subscription program that's offered from an automotive company. In Canada, the program has recently launched as well, and our Canadian colleagues will be able to fill in some more details about the specifics of that program because it is different from country to country. In the United States, Care by Volvo includes essentially everything except for gas. It includes insurance, it includes wear and tear items, it includes maintenance, it includes the car payments, everything into one flat monthly rate. We made some adjustments to the program. We continue to iterate it over time. And one of the great adjustments that we've made is via now the Care by Volvo app, you can find out your eligibility for both the insurance side and the credit side instantly. So on the Care by Volvo app, which is available on iOS and on Android, you could subscribe to a car in less than 5 minutes. We're continuing to develop the program over the next year or so, where we're going to be adding vehicles. The vehicles that you'll be driving today, some variants of them will be available now in Care by Volvo. XC90, XC60, and the V60 Cross Country are going to be added to Care by Volvo starting now. They, of course, join the XC40 and the S60. The changes that we looked for the forward for Care by Volvo is we're continuing to work with our retail partners on the not only subscription process, but on the delivery process. So we're getting to a point right now where with Care by Volvo, all of the stock is a central stock that is held at the port. We're working towards a program where you can walk into a retailer and you would be able to subscribe and get that instant delivery. And that's something that we're certainly looking forward to in the next several months. For pricing for Care by Volvo, every Care by Volvo option is between $700 and $800. So you start with an XC40 T5 all-wheel drive momentum at $700, the same for the S60 T5 front-wheel drive momentum. Then we have $750 per month, that's for the XC40 R design, the S60 R design, and the V60 Cross Country that you'll be driving today. The XC60 T5 all-wheel drive momentum also available at $750, and then at the top of the line is $800 per month, and that is for the XC90 T6 all-wheel drive momentum. So as we continue to develop this program, we're really proud now to be offering really a majority of our lineup via subscription, in addition, of course, to traditional lease and traditional financing. And we continue to see a very positive response from customers. The main focus for this program, the reason why a lot of customers are attracted to it, of course, is because it is simplicity. We have highly spec'd the cars with the most popular specs, and the customer just has to make a choice of what exterior and interior color that they want. And what we found when we were first developing the Care by Volvo program is a lot of people that were coming in to buy their first car or their second car were becoming overwhelmed with the number of options that were available as far as configurations, as far as options, so on and so forth. Then when you compound that with some of the other things like insurance and tire protection and wear and tear and everything like that, we found that there was a segment of customer that was really interested in just having everything simplified and putting it into one flat monthly rate. And as a result, we've seen that do very well, where well over 95% of Care by Volvo subscribers are first to the Volvo brand. They had not considered a Volvo before, and now that they've joined the Volvo family through this program. So we're very proud of it, and we continue to expand it. A few other programs of note, which you may have seen come up in some releases over the last few months, is we've, of course, we're working on Care by Volvo to further develop the vehicle ownership experience. But for those that are both subscribers but also not subscribers, we've added some new programs to try to make the ownership experience as lasting and as easy as possible. One of which is what we call Tow for Life. So now no matter what vintage Volvo you drive, whether you're talking about a P1800 from the 60s or a brand new vehicle, if there's a scenario where it requires a tow for whatever reason, we will offer a free tow to the local retailer. And we've seen great success with that, where we're seeing a lot of cars, specifically ones that are well out of warranty, taking advantage of this opportunity and getting it to the local retailer for repair. And so this is a benefit where, again, we're taking out the question of when you're in a scenario with an older car and there's something happened, whether it be a dead battery, whether it be a blown tire or something else, and the customer just doesn't quite know what to do. It's very simple. You call customer care, or on the newer models, you press the on-call button, and we will arrange for a tow truck to come out. We'll take it to the local retailer and assist in getting it repaired. Accident Advisor is another program that we developed that's very similar in this vein. So with Accident Advisor, is a program to help walk customers through the process of what to do in the event of essentially a fender bender, a minor accident that has no injuries. So typically what happens in this scenario is the sensors will go off, we'll be pinged that the crash sensors have gone off for whatever reason. We reach out to the people that are in the car, ask if everyone's okay. Once we confirm that there's no medical needs or anything else, we offer the opportunity to send the driver a link to an app. And in this app, it is step-by-step of what the customer needs to do in order to facilitate, you know, kind of the whole process with their insurance company and getting their car repaired. So in the app it says, take these pictures, take this amount of information, we activate Tow for Life, we send out a tow truck to come and get the car and take it to a local retailer, and then we walk with them through in gathering all the information, submitting it to their insurance company, and then assisting them in finding a certified Volvo facility to repair their vehicle afterwards. And again, this comes down to two things. One is, in this scenario, it's very emotional, and a lot of times people, even in minor fender benders, have a tendency to freeze. They don't know what to do next. And so the customer winds up becoming, I think victim is a strong word, but to just whatever the scenario is, you know, oh, this tow truck is coming and it's gonna come and pick up my car, and you know, do I get this information or that information, or you know, how do I deal with the insurance company? So what we've done is we've taken that whole process and attempted to simplify it and walk with the customer step by step through that. And the success there has also been very good. The other part of it too is often after some of these more minor accidents, customers are concerned about how their car is going to be repaired. Working directly with the insurance company, we can ensure that the car is going to be repaired to the standards that we have set for when the car first left the factory. So that way the customer is leaving with a repaired vehicle with some more confidence that the safety systems and everything else of why they invested in a Volvo are going to be repaired to the standards that they should be, even after a small fender bender or some other type of accident. Finally, the Pay Once and Never Again lifetime warranty. This is something that we've actually issued a few years ago now, but is something that we continue to invest in, where of any vintage Volvo, as long as the repair is done at a Volvo facility, we will warranty the parts and labor for that repair for the life, the ownership of the car. And so again, when you start to bring all these things together, Tow for Life, Accident Advisor, the Pay Once and Never Again warranty, it's not just about the new cars, of course, which is the bulk of what we're talking about here today, but we're really trying to extend the experience that we're providing now for the new ownership experience with subscription and stuff like that, and we're trying to expand that out further to people that have either owned their cars longer, or maybe they've bought a used Volvo, or they've bought their, you know, second generation used Volvo, or what have you. Our basic attitude is that once you're in the Volvo family, we're going to do everything that we can to try to take care of you as a customer. And a lot of these programs are a result of that, things that we've developed really over the last, I would say, 18 months. Yes?
Jim, just clarify, are these subscriber services, if I had a Volvo, I'd have to pay you to get individual ones, or are these all
It's all included. There's no subscription.
So anybody who I go and buy a used Volvo.
Go buy your 240 wagon, and you'll be under these policies. Yes. There's no additional charge. So that's, you know, one thing that we're really taking it, you know, to that, you know, used car and the older vehicles process.
What if you buy your 240 privately?
You can buy the car privately. It's the repairs. So if you do if you go and have a repair that's done at a Volvo retailer, then that repair is covered. If you do the repair yourself, we have no records of what exactly was done, so we're not able to certify it at that point. But it doesn't matter where you buy the car, as long as it's a Volvo, it's under these policies.
Once you have the repair, all of that's included?
No, the tow for life is not dependent on you having a repair done. So, you know, if you just bought the car, you know, off of Craigslist, right, and it drives off and it breaks down, you can call customer care and you can do tow for life. And you know, the same thing with the warranty period and accident advisor. If you buy the car on Craigslist, drive it 5 blocks, and then get into a fender bender, you can call customer care and you can go through the accident advisor process. I just got Lauren.
So you're saying just to confirm, there's no additional charge. I have an old P1800 and I break down to the side of the road. I come. Any Volvo dealer will tell it, obviously you want service.
But yeah.
The dealer.
Semantics, begin to Volvo customer care. Call Volvo customer care, not the dealer. Volvo customer care, they will set up the tow to the local dealer. So there's no extra charge for that.
It has to go to the local dealer.
It does.
So if you don't want them to fix it, in my case, my Volvo is old enough that they basically go, hey, we haven't seen a carburetor in 35 years. Sorry, what do I do?
If the retailer is not able to perform the repair as a result of either parts or knowledge, then there is no charge for the repair. If the retailer is able, for the tow, if the retailer is able to replace it, but you decide not to do the service, then there is a $50 fee for the tow. Does that make sense?
No. How are you reaching out? I mean, you have a lot of people out there with old cars. Do you have a campaign specifically in place to reach out? Are you reaching, using power or state data to send advisories out to people who are involved?
Yeah, I mean, so a lot of these programs are still fairly new. So the marketing machine is starting to amp up. Primarily, it's an awareness play via digital. Now it's kind of new focus on what we refer to as after sales, to get digital ads out there and try to get the message out there. We also rely on channels such as the people in this room, to be able to talk about these programs and have the information available. Yes?
If I go back to care by Volvo, what percentage of sales last year were under the care by Volvo program?
Yeah, I can't break out specifics, but what I will say is that the percentage is in the single digits.
Also related to care by Volvo, I know the rollout process was difficult because there's a lot of different state-to-state insurance regulations. Are you now in all 50 states?
We are in 49 states at the moment. We are currently reorganizing our insurance product. So right now, the way that the insurance is done is it is a individual policy that is issued to the customer. To make things faster, because what happens is when you do that, it takes 24 to 48 hours for the policy to bind, which means it's 24 to 48 hours before we can deliver the vehicle. So we are modifying the insurance process right now, and I won't go into too much detail about that, but what it will allow us to do is essentially print out an insurance card immediately with our partner with Liberty Mutual, and then we'll be able to do the deliveries. So that process, we're now operating in 7 states, and we're going to be rolling that out to all of the states before the end of the year.
What's the missing state?
New York.
New York.
Yes.
And then the other question I had is the cost delta for care by Volvo is pretty small between an XC40 and an XC90. It's $100, which is way less than it would be for a typical lease. Why is that, and why wouldn't everybody just go and get an XC90 then?
Yeah, I mean, that is something that I would probably direct more toward the finance experts that come up with those pricing. What I will say is it's a combination of looking at what the spec of the vehicle is and what they feel the demand curve is going to be for those vehicles within the program. But I can put you more in touch with the people that actually formulate the pricing if you want.
Sure, thank you. Jim, maybe an off-the-wall question, but there are
some... Oh, you never ask off-the-wall questions.
Yeah, that's
but do you have any situations where people are rejected because of a driving record and insurance issue as opposed to a great credit record? There are people out there I know who have drunk driving in situations where their insurance is thousands a year.
So the way that the insurance policy works is that there's certain parameters, and under the insurance law, I have to refer you to Liberty Mutual that can actually talk about what the parameters are, because we are not an insurance company, so I'm not able to quote specifics about an insurance policy. But basically the way that it works is that when you submit your information, so you submit it online, you submit your driver's license information and stuff like that, so both credit and insurance, either you fit in the insurance policy or you don't. So there absolutely have been people that have applied for Care by Volvo and they are not eligible because of they do not fit within the parameters that Liberty Mutual has set for the insurance policy. And I would say the same is for credit. As far as what are the ratios of people who have passed the credit and not the insurance, or the insurance and not the credit, I don't have that level of detail.
But so somebody with a really bad driving record could be rejected because of the insurance?
Because of lawyers, I would tiptoe around the exact wording of that, but I wouldn't necessarily say that they have a bad driving record, but either, if people do not meet the parameters that Liberty Mutual requires for the insurance policy, then they would not be eligible for the program.
What typically is the time that passes between the time you subscribe to a car until you get delivered?
It depends on your distance right now from central stock. We talked about our desire to get it so that you can do instant delivery at the retailer. Right now, the stock is held centrally at our ports. So it depends on your physical distance from the ports. So our ports where we hold stock for Care by Volvo is Port Hueneme in California and Newark in New Jersey. So if you're in New Jersey or in Los Angeles, you know the car can be delivered within a day. If you are in Nebraska or Alaska, depending on the transportation, it could be a few days.
What's the minimum time for Volvo Care?
So Care by Volvo is a 2-year agreement with the option for customers to change vehicles after 1 year. So in order to keep track, I'm gonna move on. These are all great questions. So if there's any other additional questions about these programs, please feel free to find me during lunch or any of the other programs, and we'll be sure to go through them.